Who is she? She is me. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today we have a wear test. We're switching it up a little bit from our tinted moisturizer since there's been so many of those releases to a new powder foundation from One Size. This is their Turn Up the Base Versatile Powder Foundation that claims to be a buttery smooth 12-hour medium to full soft matte coverage. That's a lot of claims and that's a lot to test. So I have my eyes, my brows on already. I'm ready to get into this. With any powder foundation, I think we should prime and put our concealer on prior. Now that we're all up close and personal, we can use the Secure the Blur primer from One Size on half of our face. It's supposed to be a really, really nice, just smoothing, kind of matte, silicone-ish type of primer. It's supposed to be ultra blurring though, which I'm gonna apply to this side of my face. I'm gonna be using my Armani Beauty Luminous Silk Concealer. This is in 5.75 and applying this to our under eyes and any other areas we want to just add a little coverage or highlighting. This is brighter than my typical skin color. I'm gonna just blend it out with this concealer brush since I actually don't have a sponge prepped for today. So that's on me, but since we're gonna be using more powder than not, I think we'll be okay. So now that our under eyes are all prepped and ready, I wanna make sure I didn't miss anything. I think we're good to go. Now we can apply our powder. So I picked up one shade. I bought medium shade 4. So they have these little grouped pictures. There's one for medium, which I will put on the screen right now, that has different models of each of their shades. And supposedly they did put a very strong claim that, you know, none of these have been retouched. You can see texture, you can see normal skin, etc., etc., which is not very common, you know, with a lot of website photos. Medium 4 is described as a medium with golden undertone. So that's what I went with. It looks a little lighter in the pan, but that's not uncommon for a powder. Let's take a moment to talk about this packaging. It's really cute. We have like an extended lip in the front for you to separate. You can grab one side and just open a little mirror, and it's not gonna be as pretty in a second, but let's see how it goes. I'm gonna use this powder brush. This is from Valair. It's a little round. It's the perfect amount of like density, but still fluffy, if you know what I mean. So that's what I like for my powder foundations. I want it to be able to move like this compared to a brush that's too fluffy and it just flings around. If you want like super light coverage, go for that. But if you want something that's a little bit more focused, like I don't want super packed coverage, so that's why I have something that still has that little fluff to it. But it's better than using something super dense that you would use for a foundation, because that's really packing it in. But if you want full coverage, go ahead. I'm hoping this gives me like a nice little medium moment. So we're gonna swirl. Okay, I'm just gonna tap and buff. I'm a little nervous, but this is quite buildable. Like, it's not too intense, at least currently. You can definitely layer more on the areas you want and then get that even coverage. As you can see, the powder is definitely darker than it looks like in the pan. So the pictures of the model look a little bit more accurate than the pan itself, which could fool a lot of people in store. Just try to keep that in mind. Not everything's as it seems. I don't need too much of my forehead, so we're just gonna do a really light layer and just make sure we get it into the hairline so it looks nice and blended. I didn't go all the way up to the lash line. And I gave this little like circle right here for our loose powder, which we can apply in a second. I'm bringing it towards the nose, kind of blending it up. I was kind of nervous about this, and I'm still a little nervous, just a little, I don't know, because I love, love, love. I've mentioned so many times, if you're new here, I really love the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Powder Foundation, because it's a powder foundation with the most amazing buildable to full coverage as well. But the finish is like hydrated. It's like a hydrated matte, which is what I love. And by I mean hydrated matte, I mean like a hydrated powder. When do you really get that? So this looked way more matte than something I would go for. Right now on camera, she looks pretty darn good. Like, I mean, I've seen a lot of photos, I've seen a lot of pictures, and it just made me think like maybe my skin is gonna look too dry. Right now on our unprimed side, we don't look too bad. It's definitely matte. It's definitely less like of a hydrated finish than the other. But at the end, I think I'm gonna do a little bit of a refreshing spray, because that's what I like to do with my powder foundations. This is me, myself, and I. We'll bring it down the neck. Right now the shade looks perfect. So this is what I'll look like all summer. We're heading into summer shade already, so I'll do half the neck right now. As you can see, a whole difference. Let's do the whole neck since we're already here. My heart, low-key, will always hang with powder foundations. I started with powder foundations. I'm sure I'll end with powder foundations. I mean, girl. The ease of it and the fact that it's so freaking forgiving for beginners and that it's so buildable and so easy to touch up. Like, I love powder foundations. But granted, I just love foundations. I like a BB cream, I like a liquid, I like cream foundation, like in the pans. I mean, they all have their moment. But powder, she hits. I recommend powder a lot for wedding foundations because in certain situations, powder's just gonna be better as long as you find one that doesn't look cakey. Like, you can touch it up and it will last a lot longer. Everyone always thinks you need to have a liquid. Sometimes you can pair both and get the best of both worlds. Let's look at it. Before, after, okay. Looking way more polished, way more even in one step. Let's finish off the other side. So I don't know if I would say like it looks golden. To me, it looks a little bit more peachy when it's first applied. Like, it kind of looks like the same family of what I have on my eyes. So it's not super yellow. I've definitely had more yellow before, but it could pull off just like a warm neutral. Like, I would call it more of a warm neutral since it's not full golden or full olive. So I'm putting really like a light coating around my problem areas. Like, I'm gonna lightly tap it to get some coverage, but I don't want to put too much. So we're gonna leave it alone for the most part and just buff elsewhere. This gives me flashbacks of the days of like bringing a powder brush, retractable one, to high school because I had powder foundation and just in the bathroom between classes, like, oh, I lost some coverage. Fun fact, my foot is fully asleep right now, so love that for me. On my camera right now, it is definitely glowing a little bit more peach orange, but it doesn't look bad. Like, there's definitely an undertone there that makes it pull, like, I don't look like a carrot. I don't look like a pumpkin, but it definitely has some, like, low-key undertones like that, at least at first. We'll see. Maybe the eyeshadow is just affecting my vision. So for our under eye powder, I'm gonna use Tatcha again. Tatcha's just getting really tested. I really want my opinion on her, you know, with so many different formulations because, I mean, her price tag, she ain't playing. I absolutely love these Sephora Collection brushes. If you ever see a black handled brush with like, you know, grayish type of bristles, that's a Sephora Collection brush and they are so good. I have eye brushes from them. I use them for my eye look. So good. I mean, they're a little pricier. They're better to buy in sets. They have some really good sets right now. I recommended one on my blog for the recent sale. And those are brushes like I all use, the ones that are inside the set. So if you're looking for some brushes or you find yourself in a pinch, I like them and they're so high quality, you know what I mean? Like, I have a few Morphe brushes and there are a few that I love. Like, I applied my concealer with a Morphe brush. This Morphe brush for some reason just isn't in store anymore. It's a G40, but some of my eye brushes from Morphe and some of like the random face brushes, like, I've recently tossed them because they lasted like a year or two, but then like it got really stringy. So these, way more expensive, but I don't think they're gonna be going anywhere for a while. So we got our powder on. I don't think it looks too different. It definitely isn't like super brightening. Maybe I should have used my Colab powder instead. So Tatcha has this pearlescent glow to it and you can kind of see it, but it doesn't have a lot of opaqueness. So I still feel like my under eyes look kind of Colab coming in to help with the assist. A little bit of this. Different, but it's brighter. We're not fully blended out yet. So as I bronze, let me know, what do you guys think? What do you think about the finish? I'm gonna be using Patrick Ta's new contour bronzers. I'm not gonna be using the cream since we're using powder foundation. I'm gonna try out the darker medium shade right now, which is from the She's Sculpted palette. I tried the She's Statuesque in my last video, which is this shade. I'll have her out on my desk just in case, but that's like lighter, and I think with our current base, it's not gonna work. Big, dense, fluffy brush, using like the very end hold it so I don't put too much pressure and just kind of pressing it into our hairline. Okay, I really want to sculpt out a chin chin. We're gonna do that. More of that elongated face. And of course, we gotta sharpen out the jaw. Like, the jaw needs the justice right here. This is the medium shade of this product out of the three. But I know this wouldn't work for me in winter because it would be way too tandy, but I'm glad that it's not super orangey. Like, you can see that it's giving shadow without giving burnt. Sometimes it looks different as I'm filming than when I watch it later after editing. So take everything I say with a little bit of a grain of salt. Sometimes I clarify in the pinned comment down below. Oh, that's a cheekbone right there. To be fully honest, I haven't been wearing a lot of highlight because I don't feel like any of my highlighters have been appealing to me. I definitely need something new to be addicted to. But for now, we're gonna go to a longtime favorite, the Persona Cosmetics Cali Glow Highlight. This is in Zuma, their medium shade. I'm gonna use a little bit with this brush. This is from the Bretman Rock Wet n Wild collection. And I'm gonna hit the top of my cheekbones ever so gently because this is a very pigmented highlight. Throw her right there. Keep it nice and subtle, but also gorgeous. I saw a photo from me from 2018 because they had that TikTok challenge where it's like, imagine 2018 you fighting 2021 you, which I did do. So if you wanna follow me on TikTok, TikTok you can do so. I'm having a little bit more fun, just doing little casual things here and there. But I had like gorgeous summer bronze, glowy, like highlight on anything but flat, and it was cute, so I kind of miss that. Put a little bit on my chin, make it look a little lifted. And then a little bit right here. Blend that with my finger. I need to also put a little bronzer on the sides of my nose. I did not do that. Then we gotta finish our lower lash line a little bit. So the shadows we use today are a blend of ColourPop and Makeup by Mario. If you wanna see it, it will be on my Instagram. I used two ColourPop palettes and then an assist from my, you know, ever so favorite Master Mattes. So I'm just gonna put a little bit of shadow on my lower lash line, and then a little bit of mascara. This is the Big Papa one from Wet n Wild. All right, last but not least, I think are our lips. I had lip balm on earlier, that didn't work out. I actually tried out a new primer, just a little side note, little Juvia's Place primer. Guys, it was balm.com shade 2. Wow, little lip liner. Cafe LA girl, just to get the outline. I have these from NARS. These are their soft matte tinted lip balms, which sound really great because I've tried the regular non-matte ones, like the glossier ones. We have Brief Encounter. Ooh, I like that. This is darker. This is Whiplash. She's a little too red. And then this is Intimate, which is also a good color. Okay, I want to swatch them. Okay, Brief Encounter. Okay, reddish. Intimate is a little bit more pink. Yeah, that's pink. Let's go with the more reddish then. So Brief Encounter has one. Even on my chapped lips, it's not too bad. I have this NYX Butter Gloss in Fortune Cookie, thanks to TikTok. It's applying this in the middle of my lips. The finish of the soft matte balms are basically like a cream lipstick. Okay, I like it. Cute. So right now we're looking really good. I think I'm gonna do a very light spritz of my What It Do spray. Very light. There we go, that's it. That's all we get. Doesn't really have much of like a wet finish. Just kind of trying to help everything settle as I usually would. We're looking not too bad though. So I'm gonna give you guys starting point pictures as well as close-up cam footage. And hopefully I'll have good news at the end of thy day. It is almost 9 o'clock. We've been wearing our face for 10 hours. Welcome back, welcome back. So let's look at our pictures and our close-up cam footage. For the most part, I think we look really good. I'm quite impressed with the formulation. I do have a few, you know, but let's get into the good points. So our face actually has gotten better throughout the day. I don't think I look shiny. Of course, we got our highlight going on. My nose tip is a little greasy though, which is my most oily area. But otherwise, if you're not in this center nose area, we're not at all damp or greasy, but there is a little something. But for the most part, even though it looks greasy, it looks good. And this is a powder that you can touch up with. So that's not a deal breaker. It says to touch up with it. I'm gonna touch it right now just because I would like to see how it touches up. And while I do so, let's come in close. Welcome to Pores R Us. So it looks okay. It doesn't look fresh, but it doesn't look disgusting either. So great for touch up. We love that. The coverage, she's there. Is there any denying? All the acne scars, cover. And it is quite comfortable. I don't feel like it was cakey at all. I actually forgot I had makeup on. Got a little frustrated earlier with something totally unrelated to this review. And I was like, oh, like starting to tear up. You know, took the tissue to dab my eye. Totally smacked my eyelashes up. It's actually on this eye. And I was like, oh crap, I have makeup on. And then I was really like, you ain't crying on this foundation. Cause this is not a waterproof nor transfer proof or anything like that claimed foundation. It is not for sure transfer proof, because whenever I would, you know, wipe around my mouth for eating, it would fade there. But very easy to just walk by my room and be like, and we're good to go. To discuss our primed versus not primed side, since this claims to be ultra blurring, a pore refining primer, a pore refining primer with, I say Naya, kind of like Nia Maya, but I've heard Nia a lot, like niacinamide. So anyway, that mattifies and evens out skin texture as it grips makeup for flawless application and enhanced wear. Looking at both sides, This side does look smoother. This side looks a little heavier. This just looks a little bit better. I mean, it doesn't look bad on this side. Like, I don't feel like I look cakey, but I see less texture on this side, less pore, less anything, you know what I mean? So it definitely pairs well together. So if you were looking for something to use your Secure the Blur with, this may be it. This makes sense. I mean, less oil leaking through, setting your primer with a powder. That's been a thing. You guys know it. It's been a thing for a while. That's a way to make your makeup artist last really long, so perfect duo. I saw this video on Facebook and it was, you know, one of their demo shots with their models. I heard there's a couple different ones. This was the one that was actually playing for me, and let's just observe that for a second, because they used the powder puff. And then I went back to my box and I was like, there's definitely not a powder puff. Kind of like, you know, Fenty's, where we didn't see that there was a puff. Of course, you can use whatever you have lying around. I personally think this brush did amazing for application. I didn't really like how it looked in the Facebook video with the puff, because it was like kind of stuck in certain areas, you know what I mean? Like, I think this looks better as you like slowly build it when it comes to application. A little bit more forgiving, a little bit more, you know, smooth. And that's how I like it. So I'm quite impressed, but I do think that the color is a little concerning. So I love what it looks like when I'm filming. I absolutely love what it looks like. Like, I see it in the mirror under all my lights. Fabulous, which is usually a good sign, right? Because the lights, you know, really bring out every single detail, if you know what I mean. But then when I see other lighting, I don't like it as much. I don't like it in natural lighting or like more yellow tone bathroom lighting. You know, like those situations where those ain't your light bulbs and they're just warmer. I feel like I look quite saturated. You know, I look quite orange, red tone. And it did not oxidize. In person, in the mirror I'm physically looking at, I look pretty good. But then I look at my monitor and I'm like, okay, it's gonna look a little different on y'all screen for sure. So that's a little interesting. And plus on the Facebook video, the same thing, all the comments are like, man, that's a really red tone powder. So I feel like the red tones and the orange tones within at least the medium shades, I'm gonna speak from what I see on that, can be a little concerning. Because when you look at all the shades, which I believe there are 5, 10, 15, 20, 20, I think there's 30. Yeah, I'll put them on the screen right now. 30 shades. If you focus on the medium, or my shade medium 4G, which is what we're wearing, looks a little bit closer to medium 5G in this picture depicting it. And usually pictures like this on Sephora's website are never true to color. They just aren't, especially when it comes to powders. So I'm used to that, but I'm trying to give you guys that little like gauge point where it's a lot warmer with a twist more of saturation to most of the shades. Like, I wish it looked like medium 4G in that picture, because I think that would be a little bit easier. Like, this doesn't even look like medium 4G. This looks like medium 2 in that picture in pan, and a whole different world when it's on your face. So keep that in mind when you're checking out the shades. I think a lot of the shades may have more red pigment than we are used to or we would like. So that would be the one thing keeping me from wearing this again, because I didn't like seeing that in, you know, other situations where I'm not stuck here at my studio desk. Otherwise, beautiful, blurring, perfecting, absolutely comfortable, absolutely a good powder. Not better than Makeup Forever for me, just because that matches me in a different way and the finish is a little bit more hydrating. This one is that full coverage MAC powder vibe. You know, it's giving you that. You see the makeup, you're definitely not looking hydrated. You're looking like, hey, you got a bomb powder on. What type of powder are you wearing compared to, you know, like, ooh, what type of tinted moisturizer type of finish you're wearing? Which is to be expected, it's about a foundation. And not all of them can be oddly hydrating for what they are. I would wear this to an occasion where, like, you know, everyone's coming glam. Like, that's the expectation. Probably wouldn't wear this to, like, you know, a picnic, because it's a lot for a picnic. I'm just giving you examples of the vibe it serves me. Overall, I really think Patrick did his thing. A great, you know, product. A decent shade range as far as numbers go. I can't speak for all the shades. If they're at all close to what they depict, then he definitely has variety in there. So my final grade for the one side, turn up the base, versatile foundation powder in medium 4G would be a B. Because I think it is quite fabulous. Like, you know, my texture did well. For the most part, it held up aside from, you know, where we're greased. And the shade, a little bit of a deal breaker. I feel like this could possibly be closer to a B plus if the other shade didn't have all the same tone issues. But because I don't know, and I can only see from, you know, the models they've shown, I think a B would be a safe bet, because B plus would be a little bit of a reach. And if it was a little bit more hydrating, it would have gone to A minus for me. So that's my criteria, my opinion, and my experience. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so, so, so much for watching. Keep in mind, this does not have any claims as far as transfer proof, sweat resistant, waterproof, compared to some of the other powders like the L'Oreal or the Makeup Forever that I have tested on my channel. So if you guys want to check those out, I'll put those on the screen as well as a recent upload and the subscribe button. So if you haven't subscribed yet, I would love it if you did so. And definitely drop a thumbs up on the video because that helps my channel so much. It's a free way to help me fight against the algorithm that is always ever changing. That is it for me today. Thank you guys again for spending some time with me and watching my content. I'll see you guys in a later video.